Hello,
Hello.
Rupa. I watched your series at such
Okay,
an
where are you? I don't see you. And is it okay if I don't get your name right?
Yeah, it's
Is
okay. Definitely, it's okay.
yeah, please go ahead.
Okay, so I finished watching your series in such an ungodly hour within the night. So it gives me a lot of perspective and makes me think about a lot of stuff. One of the things, first and foremost, do you want to answer, because I have several questions, do you want to answer one by one, or should I just put the questions all out there and then you answer me, or should I just
One
go
by one.
one by one? Okay. What inspired you to make such series?
Story
Yeah.
itself.
That's the first question, yeah.
Okay, so what inspired me to make such a series? The story in itself, like the stories have inspired me and kind of compelled me to be a filmmaker. So this was once a story that I had written long ago because I had seen such stories happen around me. So culturally, I don't think we are, Indonesia and India, we are that any different. We are almost similar, I think. Even though I grew up in a metropolitan city in the 90s, I think your kids were not even born when this story was happening. So in the 90s, it was like when these stories were happening, I don't know why, there was no movies made out of it. And movies have such powerful, influence on people. And I thought, it was important that this story was told. I used to write. I didn't know that I would become a filmmaker one day. I used to just write in my book and keep it, not publish or anything. I wouldn't think of anything. I would just write and keep it. And when I decided to pursue filmmaking, and after a few years into filmmaking journey, when I decided it's time I start making my own. And this was the first thing that, I always say that I threw my stories on my bed and I was looking at them and this story called out to me, and that's how I picked it up. So that's why the series was my first ever large scale thing. And yeah, I think the story is so something that the world needed to know.
You see, that's very interesting. I'm very invested because as much as Indonesia and India have the same thing, but we also have the exact opposite beliefs in certain things. And the environment in itself really astonished me, how you managed to capture from a certain angle. Even the actors themselves are very great. Like, it looks so natural, almost as if they are true people doing real things. So that's why I was very invested on it. Also, the second question, what are the obstacles have you faced in producing such series before and after you make the series?
Oh, it was the bed. It was like a complete bed of obstacles. This was in 2015, I think, when I started, when I decided that this, I will make this. Before that, I had worked in two feature films as associate, we call it co-director. So I had, I finished my film school in 2010, and then I worked in the UK. So when I went to work in UK, and I was thinking when I come back to India, I will get a red carpet welcome and producers will be waiting to invest their money into my stories. None of it happened. I had to start from scratch and I didn't know anybody in the film world here. So, so I started my journey somehow. I got a couple of feature films to kind of understand the nitty gritties and politics of this film industry here. So when I decided to, so in 2009, YouTube announced that the content that you put out there, you can monetize it. So filmmaking is an expensive art, you need to invest money, a lot of money, because it's like a composite art, there are too many artists come together to create one piece of creation. So it requires money. So my journey in the beginning few years was to know that, am I still there? Because I think, oh, Okay. So my journey was to know that how do we make films in less money? So when I kind of understood the, because I also come from, so my core academics is a financial analyst. I was a financial analyst when I was working for an IT company before. So when I understood that there are ways you can make the movies in less budget, and that's how I decided this story will be told as a web series and will be released on YouTube, because YouTube is a beautiful tool to reach too many people. Like, unless if you release in theater or if you release elsewhere, OTT platforms like an Amazon or a Netflix, YouTube, it is because it's free, you know, and it has its own algorithms where it will take too many people. So I decided we'll release it on YouTube. But then in 2015, not many knew what web series was all about. So when I started meeting people with this story, first of all, they would ask me, what is a web series and how do we get my money back? Secondly, when I said it's between two women, the love story is between two women, I was asked if it was pornography, if it was, you know, like what is the selling point? Because none of them even understood the idea of a love story between a between same gender, you know. So my initial few months went about convincing people. And second, and then while that was happening, I started looking for actors because I wanted to shoot a small episode for myself by investing my own money to see if I can carry it off, because this was something new for me as well, to see if I can bring those emotions as raw as I wanted it to look, you know, like I wanted it to look like it is happening in your own house or in the neighbor's house, you know. So when I decided to make that particular pilot, I started looking for actors. My second biggest obstacle was to find actors, because I was looking at actors who were of the same age group, like college age group, like your age group, 18, 19, 20. So with this age group, my problem was they had to go back home to get permission to act in a series, you know, like they were still not taking their decisions independently. So, and then I changed my game plan. I started looking at someone who was about 25, who can take decisions on their own, who don't have to consult their parents for their decision. So, and that's how Spurti, Shweta happened first and then Spurti happened. And so every moment was an obstacle. And I think the kind of person I am, the more it comes across as it cannot be made, I want to make it. Like I'm a very, very stubborn person, and it's pain for people around me, but I think that is what kept us going. Like every time, and there was a producer who said, who will give us money, and 2 months we are rehearsing, we are getting ready, and suddenly he said, no, my Audi car like that I had booked, it just come, and I don't have money to give you. So now we are back to, you know, zero. And then that's when I went crowdsourcing. I decided we'll do crowdsourcing. I remember the moment when we were sitting. I don't know if you guys understand the concept of crowdsourcing. It is like asking money from people. It is pretty much like begging, but for creative, to create something. Like how, you know, you see in the other cities, like in New York and all that, you must have seen in movies where people are street musicians and street artists. It's pretty much how it was. I put myself out there. I said, this is what I want to do. Just give me some money, how much ever you can do. And there was some nice plan we had made. If you give me so much, I will give you this, you know, like goodies, and you can spend time with me and things like that. Although I wasn't not like big deal to spend time with me, but you know, but that the response I got for through crowdsourcing, what gave me courage to keep going again, because a lot of people I didn't even know started giving money, you know, like few thousand rupees, Indian rupees, which itself was like, that person doesn't even know me and they're giving money to, you know, because maybe they want to see this series. And that's what gave me, it kept pushing me to go ahead. And I also took a bank loan, which I just finished paying off. And yeah, so many, many, many obstacles. So the day we released trailer, it was 2 weeks before the actual release in 2016 August, the way trailer got received, that relieved me. Until then, my heart was in my mouth continuously for almost a year, you know, like the day, the way trailer got received and the way when each episode started coming out and how it was welcomed, I didn't believe it to be true. I took almost a year to get out of that reception, you know, because when it becomes so big and, you know, like it was just too good to be true.
In one of the, I think I was finished watching a series and they recommended me something else. And in one of the interview that you did with the main actors, one of the actor actually was hesitating to start and then you talked to her and managed to talk her into playing, if I'm not mistaken. I forgot what's her name. Was it true? Like, how was the experience? Like, what did you end up persuading her with?
Okay, so Irene, how much blunt can I be in my language?
You can go as far as you want.
Okay.
Yeah.
Because Shweta, she, see, this has been a journey for them as well to make this, to participate, like, you know, to be part of this. As actors, as human beings, they evolved a lot. When we did the pilot, I don't know how much of it they understood, but then they were very open to participate in this whole thing. We would talk a lot. Like, they would ask me questions like, why do we have to do this? So for me, as like you said, you know, like you were very convinced that they were actually being their true selves, right? I wanted that to come out, and maybe somewhere we have succeeded to do that, but to arrive at that, many days of rehearsals and talking and preparations, because we would sit and talk about, they would ask me questions like, one is to romance the same gender, another is to portray first love, you know, it's, I'm sure you're at your age, you're all in maybe first or second love. And as you grow into your life, you will understand what I mean when I say the freshness, the rawness kind of goes away as you keep going into relationships, right? So for they were at an age where they had kind of come, like they were 26, 27 when they acted in this. So for them to feel the first love, for me to create an environment for them so that they can explore that. That was our big challenge. Second was to, of course, you know, romancing the same gender. So Shweta had questions and we would talk about it. And I would tell her, look, until you come to bed, you don't know the gender, right? When you fall in love, it is the person that you are falling in love with. And only the gender matters only when you are in bed together. So it's such a minuscule of this whole relationship for two people being together. And being in bed is just such a small space of their entire relationship. So I think when I said this is when she kind of finally got it, like, oh, you know, so this is how I should approach. And that's how we kind of worked on it.